فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
I ask you guys a question. Why is there so much effort put towards Islam, and that saying Islam demonizes women, Islam puts women down? When wallahi, every single music industry that you're listening to, what are they doing? I'm asking you guys a question. Huh? I'm asking a question. Music, what's the concept of music? The way that they speak about women, how they speak about women, the way they talk about her, the way they look at her, the way they draw her. The woman is a what? Exactly what pre-Islamic Jahiliyyah was. Women is a sex object. Khalas. She's nothing else, nothing. What did pre-Islamic believe? They believe the same. That the woman is a... She just gives birth. She's got nothing to say. Be quiet. Does that make sense? These rappers are only regurgitating what was previously said. Are you with me? Yeah? This is the reality. Today, me and my wife, we were talking about the other day, something regarding a woman who said that she's selling her virginity. Have you guys read something like that on there? Selling her virginity. She's a virgin. So she's selling her virginity. She got an Arab man to agree. He said he's going to meet her in Germany, and I think 1.2 million or something like that. He agreed. Two point something million that he's going to give her for zina in Germany. Billahi alaikum, is that takrim? Is that honor? She's like, I'm so happy. I can pay everything. I can do everything. What is she? She's a sex object. Wallahi, that's the underlying point. She can say how much she wants, but that's what they are pushing. They look at that as freedom. She can do what she wants. Are you with me? We look at that as exactly what pre-Islamic Jahiliyyah was. Nothing else. That is the reality. So they're playing with women, and they're trying to use them, and then the fact that they're naive. That's what they're trying to do. Another thing that I want to speak about is maylul rajul ila al-mar'ati wa maylul mar'ati ila al-rajul. So I mentioned three things. I've done an introduction. I also talked about how Islam has honored women, and now I'm moving on to the third thing. The third one is, brothers and sisters, however much a person tells you and tries to convince you that no, this girl, she's only my best friend. Okay? Sorry, a woman says, oh no, this guy is only my best friend. We're colleagues. We work at work together. We're just friends, okay? Friends. Stop taking it too much. Are you with me? I want to tell you that that's not true. That has not happened. The reality is that man has male. He has what? Inclination. Built in him from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have for women. Men have male. They are inclined to women. And women are inclined to men. We've received emails, a sister saying, this man, he always is nice to me. You know, we were best friends at first. He may not even have anything towards her. It's not always the man, but the majority of the time it's the man who has shahwa for the woman. But this sister, she's like, oh, he was nice to me. He's greeted me. We did a project in college together. We did a little project together. We did something together. And now every day I go home, I'm just crying. I want to be with him. He shaked another woman's hand. Oh, I got so angry. I got jealous. Yeah, ukhti, he doesn't know you. She's dying. She's saying all of this. Why is he doing it? Who's he to do it? Are you with me? Maylul rajuli, the man has desires for the woman. Wa maylul mar'ati ila rajuli, and the woman has it. Has it. And this is something which is jibilli. Jibilli means what? It's an innate ability Allah has built in us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has built in us that desires. As Allah said in the Quran, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ, from the signs of Allah is أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ, that Allah created from you, مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا, a spouse, a partner. When Nabi Adam was made, and Allah created him, Allah knew subhanahu wa ta'ala that he created in him desires and want. That's what Allah created for him, who? Hawa. Hawa is what? Hawa is the wife of who? Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. So Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he was what? He wasn't alone. And that is the same concept. A human is generally not willing to be alone. They need another partner in their life. Two halves make a full, right? That's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it. And خَلَقَ لَكُمْ Allah created from مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا لِتَسْكُنُوا here means what? To find tranquility. Through the other partner, you find tranquility. وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ Allah has placed between you guys مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً Tranquility and what? Mercy. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ In that there are signs لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ For people who what? Who think. Also Allah says in the Quran, زُيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ It has been beautified for the people. حُبُّ الشَّهَوَاتِ The first thing Allah mentioned is shahawat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is beautified for us, shahawat, desires. مِنَ النِّسَاءِ Like women. Are you with me? Majority of the men, if you ask them, why are you going to gym for? Ya akhi, I'm telling you now, you don't need to go to the gym anymore. The way you look, subhanAllah, you're good. Just run around your local area, yeah, around the block. But what you're doing is more than enough. You're killing yourself. Majority of them, what are they doing it for? And I shouldn't say majority, but a lot of them, what are they doing it for? For the other opposite side. Sah. That's why they come. He is what? He's putting on an attraction to get a woman. Because a man, as Allah said to us, He's placed in us men what? حُبُّ الشَّهَوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ The love and the desires for women. So whatever means we bring her, Aisha was wise. Feminist, let's compare what feminists say. I wouldn't even compare that, subhanAllah. But look at some Muslims, what they say. Feminists are not a people. But look at what some Muslims who are inclined to the feminist mindset say, and what our mother Aisha, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow His never-ending mercy on her. Look what she said. Abdul Malik ibn Habib, he narrated the Kitab Adab al-Nisa, page 187, that Aisha said, مِن شَقَاوَتِنَا أَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى جَعَلَنَا رَأْسَ الشَّهَوَاتِ وَبَدَأَ بِنَا فِي ذِكْرِهَا From our destruction, Aisha said, is that Allah started with us when speaking about the desires. This is our destruction. وَبَدَأَ بِنَا فِي ذِكْرِهَا And now He started with us when mentioning it. This is the way our destruction is in. That we are. Allahu Akbar. A woman now needs to realize that she is. She should believe that. And know that she is the number one when it comes to shahwa. And she shouldn't say, oh, why is he acting like that for? You're not wearing hijab, you're not wearing makeup. And then you wonder, you ask yourself, why is this man acting like this around you? Are you there? Then Aisha recited the ayah زُيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ حُبُّ الشَّهَوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ Aisha thought, no one should take Aisha's statement out of context. But what this statement of Aisha is saying is that the مِنْ شَقَاوَتِنَا أَنَّ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى جَعَلَنَا رَأْسَ الشَّهَوَاتِ العيني بدردين العيني in his kitab عمدة القارئ he said, وَفِتْنَتُهُنَّ أَشَدُّ الْفِتَنِ وَأَعْظَمُهَا The trials and the tribulation of women is the greatest form of trials and tribulations. وَيَشْهَدُ لَهُ قَوْلُهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ Are you with me? وَفِتْنَتُهُنَّ Their trials and tribulations, the trials that come from women, أَشَدُّ الْفِتَنِ وَأَعْظَمُهَا It's from the greatest trials. Are you there? How many brothers do I know who stopped practicing because of a woman? حَدِّثْ وَلَا حَرَجْ The brother was in a Qur'an program. He was studying. A woman, she whistled to him, khalas, he forgot everything. That's it. He forgot everything. He walked away from everything. Sometimes you think to yourself, subhanAllah, did she do sihr on him? But it's not, that's the shahwa. That's exactly what shahwa is. The man will travel around the world for that woman. I know brothers who traveled, they took a flight, they walked, because they saw a woman on what? On a screen. And they gave everything. They went, traveled to that country, went, gave all their money and booked hotels and did a honeymoon and prepared it. They've never seen this woman. Sahih? Are you with me? Then Badruddin al-Aini said, وَفِتْنَتُهُنَّ أَشَدُّ الْفِتَنِ وَعَظَمُهَا وَيَشْهَدُ لَهُ قَوْلُ زُيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ حُبُّ الشَّهَوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ فَقَدَّمَهُنَّ عَلَى جَمِيعِ الشَّهَوَاتِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He placed them in the, at the front on all of the shahwat there is. لِأَنَّ الْمِحْنَةَ بِهِمْ. Because the calamity and the trials that come from them is أَعْظَمُ الْمِحَنِ عَلَى قَدْرِ الْفِتْنَةِ بِهِنَّ. They are the greatest calamity and greatest trials and tribulations that are brought. And that's what Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّ مِنْ أَزْوَاجِكُمْ وَأَوْلَادِكُمْ عَدُوًّا لَكُمْ فَحْذَرُهُمْ. From your children and your wives are those who are enemies to you. فَحْذَرُهُمْ. Be cautious of them. Are you there, brothers? وَلِذَلِكَ when this verse came down, some of the companions got very angry. Because they missed out the opportunity of being with the Prophet, leaving Mecca and moving to Medina. They only stayed in Medina as they were about to leave Mecca and they were about to migrate and they were going to Medina. Their women said to them, are you going to leave us here? Are you going to walk away from us? Why are you going to leave us for? This, where are they heading? Rasulullah. Yeah, Rasulullah. He wants to seek knowledge, the brother. The wife will say, why are you going? Why are you going to leave us? Leave us, stay with us. And the brother loses his whole project seeking knowledge. He's preparing a dars. Why are you preparing a lesson? Spend time with us. All of that. Hadith. Wala haraj. So these sahabas, what they did was, they prepared themselves to leave and their wives told them, stay, don't leave us, be with us. So they spent time with their wives. And then this ayah came down, that from your women and your children are those who are fitna to you. So these sahabas got angry. Some of them even got ready to end the lives of their families. And then Allah says, وَإِن تَعْفُوا وَتَصْفَحُوا. If you forgive them, you turn away from them. And then the sahabas let them go. Huh? Are you with me? So what that means is what? Even the one that you're married to can sometimes be a problem. I know brothers who, because of their wives, they were practicing. Their wives said to them, honey, you look better if you just shorten your beard. Just shape it up a bit. You look nice. No line here. Yeah? You know, I don't know about this thobe. I really don't know. I really think you should start wearing the monkey suit. Should wear the monkey suit. So he's like, really? He puts the monkey suit on. He goes out, tight. Not that there's anything wrong with the monkey suit. You can wear it if you want to. You can wear it if you want to. But this, all these things. You look very charming. Allahumma barik. So what does he do? Because he's really in love with this woman, he does everything. Yesterday, a brother came up to me and he was telling me about an issue that he had. And he said, there's nothing I'm not willing to do for my wife. That's a big statement, don't say that. He said, wallahi, I'm willing to do anything for her. The marriage is not working, she wants to leave the marriage now, she doesn't want to be with him. But the way that the brother was, he told me everything he's done for her. I'm like, wow, don't tell that to my wife. Yeah. I've done this, and I did this, and I did this as well, and I did this. I was like, subhanAllah, she might be hearing us, let's just check the phone. He was really what? He was really, really adamant. But why? This is what fitna comes from it. Trials and tribulations. The fitness that come from it. So the ayah, إِنَّ مِنْ أَزْوَاجِكُمْ, from your wives and your children are those who are enemies to you. فَحْذَرُوهُمْ. Be cautious of them. Allah is telling you to be cautious of your wife. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you to be cautious of your own children. Hafidh ibn Hajar said a very powerful benefit here. He said, وَأَشَرُّ مَا فِيهِنَّ. One of the greatest evil that's in them is عَدَمُ الْإِسْتِغْنَاءِ عَنْهُمْ. You can't be without them. This is the biggest, the greatest evil that are in the women is you are unable to be without them. You can't live without them. As they say, you can't live with them and you can't live without them. Ah, it's a problem. So, عدم استغناء عنهن, you can't be without them. ومع أنها ناقصة العقل والدين. And even that though she's deficient in her thinking and also in her religion. Now what does it mean that she's deficient in her thinking? It means that a woman's clouded with her emotions. A woman's generally clouded with her emotions. She doesn't think straight. She does not think straight. Emotions would overcome her. Whereas the man, emotions is less, thinking is more. They've got more emotions than we do. Does that make sense? I remember one time a guy came up to me and said to me, are you there? He came up to me and he said to me, Islam is not a religion of justice. It's not as it claims. It says women are deficient in their thinking. Are you there? And men are what? Basically more smarter than women. I then said to him, the hadith that says, ناقصات عقل ودين, have you read the hadith in its totality? The hadith in its totality says, وَمَا رَأَيْتُ I never saw مِن نَاقِصَاتِ عَقْلٍ وَدِينٍ. Look at the context in which the Prophet said. He said, I never saw, the Prophet saying this, those who are deficient in their thinking, the aql, and their religion, أَغْلَبَ لِذِي لُبِّ مِن كُنَّا, that can make a smart man take him away from what he was doing and make him. This woman who we would say that she's not thinking straight and who we would say is deficient in her religion is able to get a smart man to fall for her and take him away, distract him. She can distract her husband, she can distract everybody. Using what? Something Allah gave her. Does that make sense? The second thing in the hadith is also that when the woman has more emotions and she has less, she thinks less, she's better than the man in the emotions that she has. Are you there? And that's equality. Her emotions is better than the man, but the man is better than her in thinking. Isn't that fair? One is better than the other one. But one has been given superiority over the other. Does it make sense? So this is what Ibn Hajar mentions, rahimahullah. And he went on to say in, وَمَعَ أَنَّهَا نَاقِصَةُ الْعَقْلِ وَالدِّينِ تَحْمِلُ الرَّجُلَ عَلَى تَعَاطِ مَا فِيهِ نَقْصُ الْعَقْلِ وَالدِّينِ. Basically, she's the one who's deficient in her what? In her thinking. She's the one who's deficient in her religion, but she takes the man to think deficiently, and she makes the man come with no religious values. She'll make him do that. That's what it means. أَغْلَبَ لِذِي لُبِّ مِّن كُنَّا. That's what she does to a man. She'll take a man and she'll make him not think straight. She'll make him not think straight. كَشَغْلِهِ عَنْ طَلَبِ أُمُورِ الدِّينِ وَحَمْلِهَا عَلَى التَّهَلُكَ عَلَى طَلَبِ الدُّنْيَا. She will turn him away from seeking Islamic knowledge and attaining Islamic deen. And she will turn him towards what? Go and she'll say, go and what? Get money for us. And he'll say, okay, I will, honey. Are you there? And he runs around making money for her. Turning away from what? Turning away from seeking knowledge. وَذَلِكَ أَشَدُّ الْفَسَادِ. And that's the greatest calamity. If every single man stops seeking knowledge and he becomes a 9-to-5 worker, then who's going to learn the religion? That's working towards the destruction of the society. Are you there? Then the Prophet said, وَاتَّقُوا النِّسَى. Fear the women. Hadith Imam Muslim in Hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri. وَاتَّقُوا النِّسَى. Be fearful of women. فَإِنَّ أَوَّلَ فِتْنَةِ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ كَانَتْ فِي النِّسَى. The first calamity that fell on the people of Bani Israel were women. Even if you look at Spain, how the Muslims lost it, Andalus. Look at the history of how they lost it. It was through the women they lost it. They lost it through the women. Even if you look at how leaders were destroyed and they were killed, one of the ways that they were killed was women were brought to them. Women were brought to them. Even today, subhanAllah, drug dealers, what do they do? In Canada, in America, what would they do is they get a girl to get this man, and when they are doing their haram, the other guy will come into the house, shoot him, take the money, and he'll take the girl with him. Wallahi, that's what they do. That's what they do in America. Why? He's weak. This man who is so like sharp. He's a drug dealer. He's looking over his shoulders every day. He's making sure that he knows who's meeting him, who's going to meet. A woman comes and she takes him off his feet. He lost control. He doesn't know what's happening. He gets caught in the worst of situations. He lets his guards down fully. Bam, 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 he gets shot. Sahih? That's how it is. That's how they do it. Ashabu Sunan, they narrated on the authority of Ibn Abbas. كانت امرأة تصلي خلف النبي. A woman, at the time of the Prophet, they used to pray behind. So the women were always at the back and the men were at the front. That's how the masjid used to be. Women at the back, the men at the front. Hasna min ajmal al-nasi. A very beautiful woman, she used to pray behind the Prophet. She was at the back, she used to pray. Very beautiful. فَكَانَ النَّاسُ يُصَلُّونَ فِي آخِرِ صُفُفِ الرِّجَالِ. A group of men would pray at the last line of the salah. That's what they would do. They would not pray at the first line or second line. There was a noble companion who used to love to pray at the back line. And he would look under his armpit in the sujood. He would look at the woman under his sujood. فَكَانَ أَحَدُهُمْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَيْهَا مِنْ تَحْتِ إِبْطِهِ. When he does ruku', he will look at her. When he does sujood, he will look at her. And some of them would come to the first line so they don't see her. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the ayah down. وَلَقَدْ عَلِمْنَا الْمُسْتَقْدِمِينَ مِنْكُمْ وَلَقَدْ عَلِمْنَا الْمُسْتَأْخِرِينَ. We know the one who comes forward and we know the one that comes back. That's the companions, people of Iman and Taqwa. People, Islam is what governs them. They fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sah? Where movies and music and pornography didn't exist. Sah? Imagine now. Abi Salih, who's Mawla Ummu Hani. You know Ummu Hani, right? Ummu Hani, Abi Salih, who was a Mawla for her. He used to say, بَلَغَنِي أَنَّ أَكْثَرَ ذُنُوبِ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ فِي النِّسَى. The majority of the sins of the people of Jannah that they fell into was because of women. Was in the affairs of women. That's what he used to say. Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib, the great tabi'i, he said, قَدْ بَلَغْتُ 80 سَنَةً. I have reached 80 years of age. Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib is saying this. I have reached 80 years of age. 80, ya ikhwa, 80. وَمَا شَيْءُ الْأَخْوَفَ عِنْدِي مِنَ النِّسَاءِ. There's nothing I fear more than women. 80. This shows you that the women's desires in men is very great. Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib said, now that I'm 80, I'm scared of women. Are you there? And then a brother's telling you, wallahi, we're just friends. We just talk here and there. She does the same. She just messages me. She just says, oh, how are you doing? How is the coursework? This is what? It is kadib. Something has to be there. There's a mission that's there. Either you guys are going to go for zina or there's going to be marriage. If you guys do marriage, then you've taken the wrong path. Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib went to say something more. He said, "Ma ay'as al-shaytan." Whenever shaytan gives up and says, you know what, I can't miscarry this person. Min shay'in illa atahu min qibal al-nisa. Except he will come to them from the side of the women. If a man can't convince you, shaytan can't convince you something, he can't make you do something, he will make a woman to make you do it. Look at this hadith. What did I just say about the drug dealers? He knows he can't, a man can't come to another man and kill him. He knows he can't do that. So through who does he come through? That's a weakness in the men. Today, look at that. Car insurance. Wallahi, just look at Sa'id Musayyib's statement and think about it. Car insurance today, they can't sell it to you unless a woman's on it. They can sell it fast then. Sah? Marketing. Car insurance. What's a car insurance got to do with a woman? But she sleeps on the bonnet. And she sleeps on the window of the car. And you see her in the picture. Boom. You just want to take annual, the 1 year insurance. Sah? They know their marketing. يَعْلَمُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِنَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ عَنِ الْآخِرَةِ هُمْ غَافِلُونَ. These people, they know their dunya. They've seen it. It works. They realize the rate it's selling is great. So they know to do that, it will sell. Whenever Shaytan gives up on something, where does it come to do? Through the women. The women are going to do it for them. The women are going to fulfill that job for them. وَلِذَلِكَ That's why Allah said in the Quran, بِاللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ لَكَدِسْ إِنَّ كَيْدَ الشَّيْطَانِ كَانَ ضَعِيفًا Shaytan's plotting and planning is weak. But when it came to the women, what did he say? إِنَّ كَيْدَ كُنَّ عَظِيمٌ You women, your plotting is great. Shaytan is weak. أعوذ بالله, he'll go. He's gone. He's finished. He's not going to be there anymore. The woman you say, أعوذ بالله, don't say أعوذ بالله about me. And she's still carrying on what she's doing. Are you with me, brothers? A brother messaged me one time. And he said to me, Akhi, I got a good job. Make dua for me. Allah makes matters easy for me. I said, what do you do? He said, MashaAllah, I work for a Muslim pizza company. Alhamdulillah, they pay me good. Pay the bills. I do everything. And I said, MashaAllah. I said, how much they pay you? He told me the price. I said, MashaAllah, that's good. That's really, really good. A while later, he calls me again. I said, Jameel, what's the problem, mashallah? Is everything all right? He's like, yeah, I need to talk to you. Fadhal, what's the problem? He said, one day I went to give a pizza at a house. I knocked. This is a pizza man. There's nothing, he does it for a Muslim company, so there's no pepperoni, whatever you're thinking about. I mean, it's halal. He's going, pizza, taking the money, he's going. Is there any mushkila? A woman opened the door for me, he said she was naked. He said, Akhi, subhanAllah, I dropped the pizza. Whatever it led to it. Basically, she couldn't pay the pizza. So we did zina. I paid it from my own pocket. But what happened is that she recorded everything. And now, my wife, my kids, I'm stressed, I don't know what. Pizza. It's a pizza man. Knocked on the door, opened it. This is what happened to him. Are you there, brothers? Fitna. Fitna. Mallahu biha alim. So whatever shaitan, this brother left jobs. Why did he leave them? He didn't want to shake the interviewer's hand. He left, not one, not two, not three, not four. He told me, I don't want to go for that job. He walked away from it. Shaitan gave up with him. In every way he can misguide him. Ya akhi, came to him from woman. ما أيأس الشيطان من شيء إلا أتاه من قبل النساء. That's true, Allah. And men are created, however much muscles they have and however tough they speak, they are weak. Humans are all generally weak, but men are weak. وخلق الإنسان ضعيفا. Men are very weak. Some of the Mufassirin, guess what they said about this ayah, وخلق الإنسان ضعيفا. Such as Ibn Abi Hatim in his tafsir. He brought from Tawus ibn Kaysan. Tawus said, "Fi shani nisa'i la yasbirna adhuna." Wa khuliqa al-insanu da'ifa is talking about men, not women. Men are weak, not women. Why? La yasbirna adhuna. They can't be patient with them. Patient here means he can't restrain himself, can't hold himself together. Are you there? How many men have you seen who are so hard-headed, who's stubborn? The minute he stands in front of a woman, he's like, okay, I'll do it for you. What do you want me to do? What happened, brother? He's the strongest, toughest man, you see. The minute he speaks to this woman, everything's like, okay, I'll do it now. Now? Want me to do it now? Okay, I'll do it now. He goes. This is the qawi, the strong, stubborn, hard-headed. This man is known in the area. No one can convince him. He's just tough. He speaks to a little young girl. He's like, okay. He nods his head. That's what he does. They can't be patient without them. Waqi' went on to say, يَذْهَبُ عَقْلُهُ عِنْدَهُنَّ His aql, all of it goes. The man is not even thinking straight. Are you there? How many people have you said to them, Akhi, Ya Akhi, listen, the girlfriend that you're with is using you. Leave this relationship first of all, it's haram. And this situation, no, you don't know her. You don't know how I see the situation. He's a big man. This man might have biochemistry, caught like, Wallahi, I've seen everything, Akhi. I have seen a lot. His aql goes. So as Waqi' ibn Jarrah said, يَذْهَبُ عَقْلُهُ عِنْدَهُنَّ When he spoke about the ayah, وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا That men are specifically created weak. That the man's aql goes. The man's aql fully goes. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he says, فَمَيْلُ النَّفْسِ إِلَى النِّسَاءِ عَامُ فِي طَبْعِ جَمِيعِ بَنِي آدَمٍ. This inclination towards women is general in all of the children of Adam. They just have it on different levels. Just different levels. Now, I just want something for people to understand. Just because a man has desires for women, it does not necessarily mean it's bad. Rather, it's praiseworthy. To have this attribute of having desires that are strong, it's good, praiseworthy. Something very, very good. It's only bad when it's being used wrongly. If the person learns to restrain himself and hold himself together and fear Allah in where he fulfills his desires, then there's nothing wrong with it. Having big desires for women is something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to the Prophet bigger than anybody else. Alayhi salatu wasalam. And it shows أَكْمَلُ فِي الرُّجُولَ, that this man's manhood is complete. وَلِذَلِكَ the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hadith sahih al-Bukhari, min hadith Anas ibn Malik, he said, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet was one, يدور على نسائه في الساعة الواحدة من الليل والنهار وهن إحدى عشرة. He would be able to be intimate with his 11 wives, عليه الصلاة والسلام. This is strength, this is power, this is the ability of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. قتادة said, I said to Anas ibn Malik, أَوَكَانَ يُطِيقُهُ, did the Prophet have this ability? He said, كُنَّا نَتَحَدَّثُ أَنَّهُ أُعْطِيَ قُوَّةَ 30. Anas said that we used to say amongst ourselves that the Prophet is given the strength of 30 men. The strength of what? 30 men. So this is unique for him. He has the Prophet, his rujula, his manhood was complete. عليه الصلاة. So it's praiseworthy. But the thing is that the person uses it correctly. Umar رضي الله عنه, what did he say? لَقَدْ أُعْطِيتُ مِنْهُ شَيْئًا. Intimacy and the strength of, he said, I have been given شَيْئًا, a great portion. مَا أَعْلَمُ أَحَدًا أُعْطِيَهُ إِلَّا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. I don't know anyone who has been given more than it than the Prophet, than me. يعني الجماع. Tabarani narrated this in his mu'jam. So this, having it is not something that a person is blameworthy for it. Rather, one of the tara'if hikayat, some of the mulah that are mentioned, the amazing stories are that Muhammad ibn Sirin, he said, Muhammad ibn Sirin said, as Tabarani narrated, رُبَّمَا أَفْطَرَ ابْنُ عُمَرٍ عَلَى الْجِمَعِ. Abdullah ibn Umar would break his fast with intimacy. He wouldn't eat nor drink. He wouldn't drink water, nor would he have dates. He would break his fasting with intimacy, would have intimate relation with his wife. And the chain is sahih, it's authentic, transmitted from him. This is the most amazing story that I read. Bayhaqi mentioned بِسْنَادٍ صَحِيحٍ عَنْ سَعِيدٍ بْنُ جُبَيْرٍ, that Bayhaqi narrated this from Sanad, which is Sahih, that Sa'id ibn Jubayr, he said, أَنَّ رَجُلٌ أَتَى مْرَأَتَهُ, a man had intimate relationship with his wife, في عُمْرَةٍ, in Umrah. They're in Umrah, they're in the Kaaba, they're out there, he had intimate relationship with her. So she said to Sa'id ibn Jubayr, asking him the question, إِنِّي لَمْ أُقَصِّرْ, I didn't shorten my hair. Meaning, he had intimate relationship with me before. I shortened my hair. So in other words, the man, the Bayhaqi mentioned it, Sa'id ibn Jubayr said that a man wanted to have intimate relationship with his wife in a state of Umrah, his wife. So his wife said to the man, but I haven't shortened my hair. My hair still, it needs to be cut. And because he was really wanted to have the intimacy, يَقْرِضُ شَعْرَهُ, he ripped it with his teeth. He grinded and cut her hair with his teeth. So Sa'id ibn Jubayr was asked, Sa'id ibn Jubayr laughed. He saw what got into him. So he laughed and he said, إِنَّهُ لَشَبَقٌ. He left the realm of thinking properly. يُهْرِيقُ دَمًا. Let him just spill a small blood. Another funny story is Ibn Habib, he narrated Kitab Adab al-Nisa. And Yunus ibn Ubaidin, صَحِبْتُ الْحَسَنَ الْبَصْرِي 30 سَنَةً. I befriended Hassan al-Basri for 30 years. I mean, I was a companion of Hassan al-Basri for 30 years. فَمَا سَمْعِتُ قَطٌ قَالَ عُزِلَ أَمِيرٌ وَلَا وُلِيَ أَمِيرٌ وَلَا غَلَى سِعْرٌ وَلَا رَخُصَ سِعْرٌ وَلَا اشْتَدَّ حَرٌ. Sa'id ibn Jubayr said, I was with him for 30 years. I never ever heard him say that, oh, this leader has gone, this leader is now being put in place, the money has gone up, the money has gone down, the weather is very hot. In other words, Sa'id Hassan al-Basri was not a person who talked about dunya, never spoke about matters related to the dunya. He will never talk about leader, he will not talk about the weather, he will not talk about the prices and the food and where they are. إِلَّا الْمَوْتُ, except death. He will only speak about death and how people are going to die and etc. I never saw him. 30 years I've been with this man. He never spoke about any of these issues. He never indulged into dunya. He always spoke about death, reminding the people of Allah. حَتَّى أَتَتُ امْرَأَةٌ, until one day a woman came to him. نَاهِيكَ عَنْ امْرَأَةٍ جَمَالًا وَالشَّبَابًا. This woman was very, she was very young. She was very beautiful. وَشَحْمًا وَلَحْمًا. And of course, this is the timings are different now. But those times it was something else. She was a bit weighted. Back in those days, the women who were chubby were loved. Even now they are, but I'm just saying that they set in the world a condition that this woman should look like this and stuff like that. Which ما أنزل الله بها من سلطان. So the woman, she's starving herself to death because they set that target that the woman has to look like. Who said this? Who said that the skinny one or the slim one is better looking than the chubby one? Who said that? من قال هذا? Nobody said that. على كل حال, she came to him and she spoke to him. ترج يدفع بعضها بعضا. فترامت جالسة بين يديه. She sat right in front of him, Hassan al-Basri. ثم قال, she said, يا شيخ, شيخ, أيحل لرجل, is it permissible for a man أن يتزوج على امرأتي وهي شابة جميلة ولود? Is it permissible for a man when his wife is very young and she can have children for him to go and marry another woman? Is it right for him? Is that something he should do? Hassan al-Basri said, نعم. Yes, it is permissible for him. أحل الله له أن يتزوج أربعا. Allah permitted for him to marry four. قال, she said, سبحان الله. The woman said to Hassan al-Basri, سبحان الله, exalted is Allah. قال, he said, نعم, Allah is exalted. قال, she said, بعيشك لا تخبر بذلك الرجال. She said, as long as you live, don't tell that to the men. The woman said to Hassan al-Basri, as long as you live, don't tell that to the men, that they can do that. Don't tell them that. ثم قامت منصرفة. Then she stood up and she left. فأتبعها الحسن البصري ببصري. He followed his eyes with her. He looked at her. حسن البصري. ثم قال, he said, ما ضر امرأ كانت هذه عنده ما فاته من دنيا شيء. This woman, as long as she's with a man, he can lose the whole world if he wants to. If he lost the whole entire world and he just has her, it's worth it. Hassan al-Basri said this, rahimahullah, rahmatan wasi'a. Inshallah ta'ala, we're going to conclude there because of the class that's going to start. We're going to be speaking about tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala, the wisdom behind wearing hijab and a little bit matters. Then inshallah ta'ala, next week we will start the kitab Jilbab al-Mar'at al-Muslimah. Anybody who has any need for the book, just write your name down on the paper, inshallah ta'ala, and I will bring you the book, inshallah ta'ala, for you, inshallah, and then you can pay bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. So just write your name down if you want the book, and I advise you, if you're coming, to buy the book. Because this book is amazing in the way it speaks about the hijab and everything. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.